Hey friends, welcome back. So great to have you back on the podcast or the vlog today. The next couple of episodes are going to be focused on some really simple, straightforward, easy tips for getting more out of your tea drinking experience. As an herbalist, I am constantly learning more ways to take what I'm already doing in my holistic lifestyle and get more out of it. And that is really what I want to help you do as well, is to live a more holistic lifestyle with ease. This doesn't have to be hard, and we can leverage more out of the things that we're already doing. So many of us, when the weather starts to get cold, start to grab the warm beverages. I'm always going to encourage you to grab a cup of tea over the coffee, because I think that so many of us are already overstimulated and overstressed. We're taxing our cortisol and our adrenaline levels are out of control. And a lot of us are in various states of burnout or chronic stress. So rather than learning how to basically amp yourself up all the time, I want to start steering you more towards some other warm beverages that might have other types of benefits that in the long run will be more helpful for your energy level. And one of those things that I think is so powerful, but we don't realize how powerful it is drinking herbal teas. Another word for herbal teas is tisane, T-I-S-A-N-E. And these are teas that typically are not going to have any significant caffeine content in them. Now, when we think of tea, very often we might think of some really common types of tea that maybe we even drank growing up, something like a cup of chamomile tea for before bed, or maybe some peppermint tea when we had an upset stomach, things like this. The truth is that there are so many herbs that you can use in infusion, which is basically another word for making tea. But when we make an infusion, we want to do it in such a way that we extract the maximum amount of benefit from the plant material that we have in that tea. Now, I always thought that I was making my teas, my herbal teas, the right way. Here's how I used to do it. I would boil my water, and while I was boiling my water, I was getting my tea material ready. And I like to drink loose leaf teas. I'm going to be talking about the benefits of loose leaf tea over tea and tea bags in the next episode. But so I'd be getting my tea together, and as I would let the water boil and then cool a little bit, and then I'd pour it over the tea and I'd walk away for 5 to 8 minutes. And usually I'd use like a teaspoon of plant material, but that could vary according to whatever I was steeping. What I have recently learned or been re-reminded about is how important it is to infuse your teas by using a lid, okay? So here's what I used to do, if you can see this on the vlog. I would just get a cup of tea, I'd throw my tea bags in there, and I'd let it steep, I'd walk away. I would leave the top of the teacup open. Well, here's why you don't want to do that. When you do that, all of the aromatics, all of the essential oils, the volatile oils, even some of the herbaceous compounds that are ones that can be evaporated essentially, are going into the air in your home or wherever you're making your tea, which means that they're not going into the teacup. And many of those compounds are the ones that we look toward to have the health benefits that we're looking for, also the flavors that we're looking for when we drink tea. So if you haven't maybe been drawn towards tisanes or herbal teas because they have tasted weak to you or you didn't really experience benefit from them, one of the reasons may be that that tea wasn't steeped properly, wasn't infused properly in the first place. So here's what I do now. I have my teacup and I like to use metal infusion baskets that are the same size as the teacup or roughly the same size as the teacup or mug that I'm going to be using. I put my teaspoon or so of my plant material in there, boil my water, same as before, but as soon as I pour the water over this, I put a lid on the top. And I put a lid on the top, and then I let it steep for at least 15 minutes. So these are the two mistakes I was making. I was not using a lid, and I was not steeping for long enough. Some of the compounds in the tea take longer to be extracted from the plant material into the hot water. So when you're not steeping long enough and when you're not recapturing those volatile oils and such things by letting them hit the lid of your, the top of your lid, then they recondense and they go back into the water of the tea. You're essentially keeping those captured in your tea. And I cannot tell you how much better this is. This is such an easy tip, you guys. It's such an easy thing to not do or to think that's not important. But let me tell you, my tea drinking experience has changed dramatically since I've been doing these two things. There is much greater flavor. I notice an almost immediate noticeable benefit that whatever I'm trying to get out of the tea, I notice it right away. I notice a deeper impact or effect in my body. So for example, the other night, I wanted to just really relax. I was taking a social media Sabbath, and I really wanted to calm down my central nervous system. I really wanted to go very, very deeply into rest and digest. So I did an infusion of a couple of different nervin herbs. So in that, I had skullcap, I had wood betony. I threw a few dashes of a few other things in there too. So I made my tea water, I got my teacup ready, I put the lid on and I infused it for, gosh, I think it was 15 to 20 minutes. The thing about when you infuse with a lid, it also doesn't cool very fast. So it gives you longer to allow it to cool, which is nice because sometimes I want to just make the tea and walk away and go get something else done and come back to it, which is what I did. And then when I sat down to actually drink the tea, there was so much more of a complexity in the flavor profile of the tea. It was almost like the difference between drinking a really cheap, crappy wine and a wine that has been grown in amazing conditions with great care from old vines, okay? So this was like a really rich flavor experience. And almost immediately upon drinking that tea, I started to notice that my muscle tension, my headache that I had started going away. I started to notice that I almost like went into sort of a spaced out state, which is what I was going for. And I felt so much of a greater depth of relaxation. Not only that, but that night then I slept and I felt so much more nourished from my sleep than I normally do. So this little tip can make a huge difference for you in your tea drinking experience. And again, what we're going for is putting some kind of a lid. I don't care what it is. If it can be a plate, it can be a little plate that you have that you just set over there. And then second part of the tip is to let it steep for at least 15 minutes. So really simple, easy tip today, not a long podcast. I'm going to be talking more about teas, how to infuse teas, different ways to infuse teas, also differences between tea bags, things you might want to look for, things you might want to avoid when sourcing your tea. All of these things are going to be coming up on future podcasts, so be looking for those. But for now, I want you to go home and I want you to make a cup of tea like this and leave me some comments and let me know if you noticed a difference and what the difference was for you. So that's all for today. Please comment, like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell so that you get notified when there's new vlogs. And for those of you on the podcast, I really do appreciate those 5-star reviews. And if you would share this work with anyone else that you know it would benefit, and I will see you next time.